Hello students, welcome back to the fourth part of the video on dielectrics. Okay, so in this video we are going to discuss the concept called dielectric breakdown. So you know what is dielectric breakdown? Normally when the external field is applied on any device in which the dielectric material is used, where the charges are stored in the device, okay, sometimes the high electric field will damage the device itself. Okay, so that kind of destruction type of phenomena is called dielectric breakdown. Let us see what it says here. See, if a dielectric material is placed in a very strong electric field, electrons can be torn from their corresponding nuclei, causing large current flow and damaging the material. So that is why this kind of phenomena is called dielectric breakdown. Okay. So the value of applied electric field at which dielectric breakdown occurs is called the dielectric strength of the material. Okay, that means what is the capacity, okay, up to which the dielectric material can withstand the applied high electric field. That is called dielectric strength of the material. So, or we can say dielectric strength is the maximum electric field. So that is dielectric material can withstand without suffering the electrical breakdown. The dielectric strength of the material is also denoted by a EBR. EBR indicates the strength of the applied field up to which the dielectric material can withstand without breakdown. So it is called EBR here. Okay? Now the dielectric strength of a material may vary by several orders of magnitudes depending on the various factors, including the exact composition of the material, because there are various types of dielectric material. So depending upon the composition in the material, okay, the dielectric strength depends here. Usually dielectric breakdown does not permanently damage gases or liquid dielectrics, but it does in the solid dielectrics. That means normally this kind of phenomena happens in the solid dielectrics, not in the gases or liquid type of dielectric materials. Clear? Now let us see some examples here. So if you consider the air as a dielectric material, what is the dielectric constant? It is equal to 1. So dielectric strength is how much? 3 in the order of 10 to the power of 6 volts per meter. It is 3 into 10 to the power of 6 volts per meter, like that. Similarly, bakelite is one of the best dielectric material. So dielectric constant is normally 4.9. So its dielectric strength is 24 into 10 to the power of 6 volts per meter. That is why it is called good dielectric material, bakelite. Okay. Fused quartz is also having nearly same 3.78. Okay. Is the dielectric constant. And its dielectric strength is 8 into 10 to the power of 6 volts per meter. Like that. So there are various examples are mentioned here. Okay. So for example, last one is water. Dielectric strength is very high, 80. Okay. But we don't know exactly what is the dielectric strength. So, because it is a liquid, you cannot measure the dielectric strength for water as a liquid it is. Okay. Now, let us see the different types of dielectric breakdown, the mechanisms. The first one is intrinsic breakdown. It is a kind of avalanche breakdown or Jenner breakdown, as we study in case of diodes. Okay. So, where the applied electric field in the reverse reverse bias of the diode may damage the diode. Okay, so that is the avalanche breakdown. So the thermal breakdown also occurs sometimes due to the temperature of the dielectric. Okay, when it is heated, so the dipoles will be thermally agitated and they will not support any internal field. So that kind of breakdown is called thermal breakdown. And similarly, the third one is discharge breakdown. Okay, in case of discharge breakdown, again the charge distribution are concentrated at the edges. Okay, so they dissipate into the surroundings. Okay, discharge takes place into the surroundings and loss of charges happens in the dielectric material. So that kind of breakdown is called discharge breakdown due to dissipation of charges into the space. The fourth one is electrochemical breakdown. So this is similar to thermal breakdown. Okay, so but here during the flow of current, okay, so the molecules and atoms get heated and then due to some chemical equations, so they will not support for any formation of internal field in the dielectric. So the loss of charges may take place in the material. That is called electrochemical breakdown. Similarly, defect breakdown. So this is basically depending upon the material. If the material consisting of more number of defects in the arrangement of atoms or molecules inside, so that is also not supporting for the formation of internal field and storage of the charges, etc. So that kind of dielectric breakdown is called defect breakdown. Clear? Okay. Now the next concept is piezoelectric. So a material that develops voltage upon the application of stress and develops strain when an electric field is applied. Okay, so this is the phenomenon called piezoelectric material. So now to understand this, you just look at the figure. In the first figure, okay, this is a dielectric material. So P is equal to zero. There is no polarization. Okay, so once you apply certain mechanical force on the material, automatically due to this stress, mechanical force or mechanical stress, some kind of dipole moment takes place, okay, due to the alignment of dipole moment in one direction. So it gives certain induced voltage across the dielectric material, so that you can measure that induced voltage using a voltmeter here. So that means EMF is generated across the dielectric material due to the mechanical stress here. So that phenomenon is called piezoelectric phenomenon. So here the Converse effect, you can see the Converse piezoelectric effect also. What do you mean by that? So instead of applying the stress to reduce the dimension, you apply the voltage itself. Directly you apply certain voltage. As you increase the voltage, the size or dimension of the dielectric decreases, either in this lengthwise or breadthwise, depending upon in which direction you are applying the voltage, the size or dimension decreases. Okay. If you reverse the field, its dimension increases also. Like that, the dimension can be varied by applying certain high electric field or applying certain voltage across the dielectric material. That is called Converse piezoelectric effect. Clear? So the first one is direct piezoelectric effect. The second one is Converse piezoelectric effect. Here also we can see the piezoelectricity, application of pressure produces the current or voltage. Okay. Now, this in the piezoelectricity, the process of creating electric polarization by mechanical stress is called the piezoelectric effect, as you know in the previous slide. This process is used in conversion of mechanical energy into electrical energy, right? The first piezoelectric direct effect, or electrical energy into mechanical energy also. So converse is also possible in piezoelectricity. According to inverse piezoelectric effect, when electric stress is applied, the material becomes strained, isn't it? So this strain is directly proportional to the applied field also. Okay. So what kind of materials will exhibit this kind of piezoelectric property? You can see some examples here. Quartz crystal, okay, Bruchelle salt, etc. So piezoelectric materials are piezoelectric semiconductors such as gas, okay, zinc oxide, CDS, okay, cadmium sulfide, are finding applications particularly in ultrasonic amplifiers, you know. That is the application of piezoelectric properties. Okay, now the next phenomenon is about electrostriction. So what do you mean by electrostriction? Look at the definition. When any material undergoes polarization due to the application of electric field, so its ions and electronic clouds are displaced. That is called polarization, right? So causing the development of mechanical strain in the material. Mechanical strain is observed during the polarization. So that phenomenon is called electrostriction also. Okay. The next phenomenon is with the dielectric called electret. So electret formed by the words electricity as et, from et is from magnet. Okay. Electret is from electricity. Combining these two words, it is called electret. So electrets are materials that have a quasi permanent electric field at their surfaces due to either an imbalance of charge at the surface, so that is called space charge electrets, or to aligned dipoles through the bulk of material, dipolar dielectric. They are called dipolar dielectric. Means either you can have space charge electrets or dipolar electrets, depending upon the mechanism. Okay. So electrostatic properties of electrets have been exploited for many applications, including, you can see here, xerography, okay, powder coating, and electrostatic precipitation. Okay, various applications you can see in electrets. Now, to mention some devices here, applications of electrodes as electret microphones. Okay, so they work at high frequency, even up to few megahertz also. So they can use in hearing aids also. Okay, then detection of air pollution and removing of micro particles also it is possible using electret filters. Okay, then electret as used as electrochemical transducers. You know, so that is for example phonographic cartridge. Okay, relays etc. And then electrets used as a coil electrets. Okay, used in healing process of fractured bones. Fractured bones can be healed by using coil electrets. Here, these are some applications of electrets. An electret carries a permanent electric field. So just as permanent magnet carries a permanent magnetic field, so like that from electret you can expect the permanent electric field also. So by this advantage, so one way to of thinking of electret is as a capacitor. It is as a capacitor that always carries a charge and that you need not to recharge it again. Okay, so it is always giving the electric field. So except when you make it initially or something bad happens to it, such as it's melted or something like that. Otherwise it is continuously giving the electric field like a capacitor. Need not to recharge it again. That kind of metal is called electric device. Okay, here some problems I have mentioned from this dielectrics. Okay, so just one example let us see. So determine the capacitance maximum potential difference that can be applied to Teflon. Teflon is a dielectric material filled with parallel plate capacitor having a plate area 1.7 centimeter square and plate separation of 0.04 millimeter. So you know the equation for capacitance of a capacitor as C is equal to K into epsilon naught A by D. Okay, so it is direct substitution of the value of K. Dielectric constant is given. Okay, so what is that? So epsilon naught value it is, and then 1.75 into the power of minus 4 meter square is the surface area A. Okay, and then so D value separation it is, okay, 0.04 mm is nothing but 4 into 10 to the power of minus 5 meter converted it is to SI units. Calculate, you will get the capacitance 8.13 10 to the power of minus 11 farad. So it is equal to 81 picofarad also. And then you calculate the delta V maximum. Okay, it is asked to calculate maximum potential difference. You know, calculate potential difference as E maximum into D. Okay, so just substitute it as 60 into 10 to the power of 6 volts per meter. So that is actually the value obtained for applied magnetic field, maximum withstanding applied magnetic field. So multiplied by calculated into D separation between the two plates it is, and then you calculate the value as potential difference equal to 2.4 kilo volts. Clear? So one more example let us see. A parallel plate capacitor is constructed using a dielectric material whose dielectric constant is 3 and whose dielectric strength is 2 into 10 to the power of 8, it is actually 10 to the power of 8 volt per meter. The desired capacitance is 0.25 microfarad and capacitor must withstand a maximum potential difference of 4000 volts. Find the minimum area of the capacitor plate. Okay, the value of K is 3. E maximum is given 2 into 10 power of 18 volts per meter. Okay, so that is also equal to delta V maximum by D. So C can be calculated as usual by the formula K into epsilon naught A by D. Okay, then area you need to calculate. So cross multiply the equation for A, CD by K epsilon naught. Okay, then substituting all the given values of C, delta V, K epsilon naught, E maximum, you will get the value of area of cross section required for a capacitor plate is 0.188 meter square. Like that you can do some problems related to equation for capacitor. Clear? Okay, so it is all about the dielectrics. Thank you for watching and all the best for your studies. Okay, but please don't forget to subscribe and share my YouTube channel Dr. Physics AYST. Okay, thank you.